Because great success always starts with a seed, and that seed is your idea. And for that to grow, you need to take risks, and that's important to understand. So I'm here today to talk about tomorrow's leaders and how you can be a force for good. You know, I started the charity when I was 12 years old after I was bullied at school. I was in bottom sets because I was dyslexic and tongue-tied, and told a teacher that I wanted to learn, which led to me being assaulted in my school. And after that, I decided I wanted to make a difference. I wanted to change the perception. I wanted to make it cool to care. Cool to care for yourself, for others, and the wider world. But when I first started in Pinewoods, there was no one out there for me. No programs that I could go on to get the skills that I needed. So we designed education programs that gave young people like you the skills that you need to overcome adversity, be successful, and lead change. My vision is very small to me, but big to a lot of other people. And again, it's a risk. My vision is to start up a global leadership foundation, to give out scholarships to young people like yourselves around the world, to give them the opportunity to take a step forward and make a difference for the lives of others. But not only that, to raise funds for an international village, to provide respite for vulnerable young people who've been abused and raped at home. A lot of people ask me what my motivation is. It's very simple. It's to support victims, the victims to become survivors, and to give them the skills to lead change, to help them make a difference to the lives of others. And this is the village that we're trying to fundraise for, to get young people like you running it, delivering, and teaching other young people to survive. A lot of people ask me what a young pioneer is. A young pioneer is anyone, regardless of age, whether you're 6 or 68, it doesn't matter. Anyone can be a young pioneer. Because a young pioneer is a young person who leads the way, an innovator who takes the first step to get things going, makes a positive difference to the lives of others. Every young pioneer teaches and trains other young people, passing on an I can do approach to life, and thereby demonstrating that it's cool to care. So what we do is very simple. We go into schools like yourselves. We also do alternative education. We provide scholarships for young people who've been raped and made homeless. We do massive events. We also have young people who teach other young people, and also a good one for you, young people who teach their teachers. They'll come in, they can teach your head teachers, the teachers that teach you. Now I know a lot of people that would love to do that, and that's something that we like doing with young people, giving them that opportunity. We go into primary schools, secondary schools, provide out days for young people, and we go in to provide our courses always with young people, because we believe that young people are the start of the future, and they will change and have a massive impact. I always hate this slide, because not only have I got that awful picture of me up there, but because it shows how many awards we've won. We don't put ourselves in for awards, other people do. For example, this year I had the honour of delivering the inaugural Churchill lecture, the first time any young person has delivered that speech. Our programme also won the Training Journal Best Charity Programme, and I was on the face of the Metro, which is a really bad picture. But I was on the face of the Metro for becoming the first ever young person for the ING Decency Award this year. And it's important to see that at any age, you yourselves can make a difference. You can stand up in your classroom, as a youth MP, as a youth mayor, it doesn't matter, but you can make a difference. I always say that you're a pebble in a pond, because you're creating ripples, and those ripples will create change. And it's not rocket science, because being a tomorrow's leader, it's about turning dreams into reality. And your dreams are reality. They're just waiting to happen. It's about having a positive attitude, being motivated, because believe me, it is hard work. And as you stick to it, you can see a big change. I'm going to ask you 3 questions. I want some audience participation, not just from the young people, but the teachers and adults in the front row as well. So who is this at age 8? A very naughty boy, a constant trouble to everybody, and is always in some scrape or other. He cannot be trusted to behave himself anywhere. Any ideas?
Boris Johnson.
Boris Johnson? Howard Henry? Anyone else?
Henry.
Me? No, I think my mother would agree with you there, but I think I'm perfect in all sense. Any other answers?
Richard Branson.
Richard Branson? So Winston Churchill. Who's head teacher told him this? Congratulations. I predict you'll either go to prison or become a millionaire.
Yes.
Richard Branson. And that's important, because we see a lot of people getting told negative things, young people, from such ages of 8 years old and upwards. Don't listen to that negative voice. Believe in yourself and turn your dream into reality. And that is why we're here today, all of us, is to tell you that you can turn your dreams into reality. You know, when I look out into the audience, I don't see skilled children. I see the next Prime Minister. I see the next CEO of a global company and global charity. But all of you will be a force for good. So Winston Churchill made a quote in 1956 by saying that we were facing problems, perils, challenges, and opportunities. And I asked the question, what are those problems, perils, challenges, and opportunities? And how can we tackle them? I walk out into Britain and I look at the newspaper. I look at the TV screens. And they always tell me, we're a broken Britain, a moral collapse, a social decay, and a disaffected youth. They see young people in a negative manner, as unloved, unhappy, and out of control. They see us with a lack of motivation, and I hear it all the time. And I'm 17, and when I go into a board meeting, the adults always say, in my day, you've always had it, you've never had it as good as you do now. But I always think, well, actually, a lack of motivation isn't the problem. It's the fact that we have a negative voice talking to us, from the adults above us and the press around us. But it's up to us as young people to take that first step forward and make a difference to the lives of others. I had the opportunity of meeting Bill Clinton last year, and he told me his quote from his parents. They said that times were harder, and they probably were. But what was different is that they had hope. Young people wake up every day and look in the mirror and see themselves staring back with no hope. You need hope, because it is you who will make a difference to the lives of young people, now and in the future. Young people in the UK, 12% of our population is made up of 16 to 29 year olds. 155,000 of those are not in education, employment or training. In the UK, we have the highest rate of under 17 year olds living in households with income less than 50% of the national median. And child well-being is the lowest in all OECD countries. I can't believe that, and I'm sure many of you can't believe that. But it is up to us to change these facts. Poverty in the UK, inequality, is back to where it was at the end of World War II. In 1979, 1 in 10 lived in poverty. Today, over 3.6 million children live in poverty. That's 1 in 4. The effects of poverty are devastating. The fact that a boy born in Manchester is expected to live 7 years less than a boy born in Barnet, and that a young person leaving care only has £1.50 per day for all their food. That's their breakfast, their lunch, and their dinner. Childhood obesity is a rising problem. In 2008, the number of obese people in the world exceeded the number of people suffering from malnutrition. Childhood obesity is going to be one of the biggest problems. Churchill made a challenge to us, and that was to perform our common duty to the human race. But how do we do that? How are we going to do that? Because we need you to do that, and you can do that in any way, anything that you can think of. As Mr. Blake has done with Windlesham, you can adopt us. You yourselves can fundraise for a cause or a social action point and make a difference. We can come in and teach you enterprise skills and take part in a surviving company, where all the profits raised from that go towards providing scholarships for vulnerable young people. Whether that be in an ICT procurement, which we'll go into a little bit later, creating banners, posters, or even making your own uniforms, we have the ability to give you the skills to make a difference to young people. When we talk about ICT procurement, I always think it's rather quite boring because it's computers, it's clickers, it's microphones, it's everything that you see in a school. But if your school were to buy these products through this portal, the money raised would go towards providing scholarships for young people around the world. Or you yourselves could go through Tomorrow's Leaders program, learn about how you can make an active difference to the lives of young people. Start off by going through the Tomorrow's Leaders program, learning about effective communication skills, leadership skills, enterprise, marketing, impact evaluation. You yourself can take part in live philanthropic activities, making a difference to the lives of young people, and in the end, becoming an agent of change. The program is very simple. And when a young person comes to us in this program, we never ask them to fundraise for us. We always teach you to not be a pebble, but to be a concrete brick. To not make ripples, but waves. All the funds raised go towards other charities, providing young people with opportunities around the world. And points 4 and 5 for us are important to say, because points 4 and 5 are sponsored by Canon, and Canon are working with us to provide opportunities for young people like yourself. We also work with a company called YP Wild Trucks, creating opportunities for you to travel to Africa, to do field studies, and to have social action in Africa. You yourselves can be that agent of change, whether that be here or overseas. It doesn't matter, because you are turning dreams into reality. The future is not tomorrow. The future is now. As we look ahead, the leaders will be those who empower others, and those leaders are you. A lot of people ask me, I can't do all that straight away. I can't be a youth MP. I can't be an MP. I can't be the next Prime Minister. Yes, you can, and all you have to do is start with one simple thing, and that is smile. When you wake up in the morning, look in the mirror and smile. I do it and I think I'm ugly, but that's beside the point. But you need to do that. Smile at yourself, then walk out of your home, walking down the street, smile at another person and 2 other people. Passing on that smile, you're making people feel happy. Then they'll smile to someone else and it'll make their day brighter. One simple step can make a huge difference. Thank you for listening.